If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture in GATE measurement series. So today we'll be solving question number 6 onwards, 6 to 10. 5 questions. Okay, then let's try to solve these questions.
Okay, student, if you see question number 6, when a Houston bridge shown in the figure is used to find the resistor Rx, this is Rx. The galvanometer G indicates zero current when this happens. R3 is known as 5% tolerance on its nominal value of 100. On its value of 100 ohm, that is 5% on this 100. What is the range of Rx in ohm? Okay, so in Houston bridge, you know this into the balance condition occurs, and this into this is equal to this into this, or you can think this by this equal to this by this, this by this equal to anyway. So this into this equal to this into this. So if I use this one, R1 into Rx is equal to R2 R3, which means your Rx is equal to R2 R3 by R1. So what is the worst case one? You can take log like this one, question number 5, similar. You can see Wx is equal to xy by z. So in worst case, everything will be added. You know how I have explained here why it is added. Even if it is minus, why I am adding it. So because they are of different quantities. So what is the formula? So drx divided by rx equal to, you can apply this one directly from here, plus minus dr2 by r2 plus dr3 by r3. And then dr1 by r1. So these are, they have given errors in only r3. So these are zero, no error is there. So this is plus minus. What is dr3? These are absolute change, not in percentage. It is 5% of 100. So 5% of means 100 means 5. So it is 5 divided by, these are zero, these are zero. And what is r3? r3 is 100. So it is 5 by 100. Okay, plus minus. So what is their axiom in terms of percentage? No, direct value. So you calculate drx, so that will be multiplied by rx. Now what is its rx? Normal condition, it should have been 100 into 65 r2 r3 divided by 50. So it would have been a 130. So it is plus minus 5 by 100 into 130. So if you do it, it is 6.5 plus minus. So your answer will lie between plus minus 6.5 of this 130. 130 plus minus 6.5. So you can see it is 136.5 and here it is 123.5. So that is your option A. Now in case of question number 7, the following measurements are obtained in a single phase load, V equal to this much, I equal to W equal to this much. If the power factor is calculated using the measurement, the worst case error. Again, same type of questions. So you know what is power factor? Power factor equal to W, that what, divided by VI. Because VI cos phi, W is equal to. So what is the worst case? That is dPf by Pf is equal to plus minus. Again, everything will be added, dW by W, dV by V plus dI by I. So you can put all these things there. So what is dW? dW is 2% of 550. So 2% of 550 divided by 550 plus. What is dV? dV is 1% of 220. So divided by 220 plus. dI is 1% of 5 ampere divided by 5 ampere. So 5, 220, 220, everything will be gone. So it will be 213 plus 14%. That is 4 by 100. So in terms of percentage they are asking. So dPf by Pf into 100, error in percentage is equal to, you multiply by 100, that is 4%. Both side multiplying by 100, so you will get it is 4% error. So that is your answer. Similar question it was. Two resistors with the normal value of resistance R1 and R2 are having additive uncertainty is this. When the resistance are connected in parallel, the standard deviations of the error in equivalent resistance in R. Okay, what is standard deviation? If you see, your standard deviation is root D square by N. That is deviation of D means it is the deviation from the mean. How you all the standard deviations means you are trying to find how scattered your data is. Means you have collected lots of data. How scattered it is, how widely spread it is. So you have a mean and all other data are at same distance from the mean. So you are calculating all the distances. If the distance is more, then your SD will be more. That means your data is more scattered. If all are concentrated at same point, that means your SD is small. That means all data are at concentrated at one point. That is the meaning of standard deviation. So here D is the difference from the mean. You take all the difference, then you take square, then divide. Why is squaring? Because there are, it can be plus 5 or 2, it can be minus 5 also. So this If you directly add plus minus, then it will be zero. You will think that there is no distance between these points. But here the minus doesn't matter. I just want to see how scattered it is. So this, that's why to nullify that one, that's why it is squared. Squared and then it is taken root. This can also be approximated to your RMS value. Your RMS value also something like that. Can you feel it? It was first root means square. Root, then your mean means this. Root, then mean, then square of the signal. Whatever Vm square, sin square, omega t, whatever you have taken. So what was the case for, it is same similar thing of this. You can see of this fashion. So if there is a mixed signal, you have solved loss of mixed signal, 5 plus 4 sin omega t. So what is the RMS of the mixed signal? So when you calculate overall RMS was V1 RMS square plus V2 RMS square. Something of this fashion, we have solved lots of questions. I think here only in question number 4 or some questions, I think question number 2, second question only we have solved in the earlier lecture. See this signal, when you calculated RMS, in networks also we have solved. So here also it is same, if you want to calculate overall, but here is a little catch there, we will explain it well. Delta 1 square plus delta sigma 2 square. So if you take this one, you will get the sigma, like your RMS value, you can remember in that way. But here we have taken the full signal and then we have calculated the RMS here also. But here the error is given on delta R1, delta R2, that means on R1, R2. But suppose I am not going for parallel combination, I am going for just a normal, suppose your Z is 2X plus 3Y. So you know the error in X, you know the error in Y. But this error in X, how it will propagate to Z, it is not simple propagation because you are not taking error on 2x. Are you taking error on 2x? If you take error on 2x, then you can do this one. But you are not doing so. And here you are taking the whole signal. So that's why here nothing extra has to be done. But here you want to see how x error is propagating in Z. If there is a change in x, how it will affect in Z. So that's why you have to calculate this one. dz by dx is your 2. So error in x should be multiplied with 2. Whatever, if there is a change in error in x in 1 ohm, then the change in z will be 2 into 1, 2 ohm. So this is for effect of x. So whatever x you are doing, so what delta x will get affected 2 into delta x. Similarly, if there is a delta y, the delta y will propagate here 3 into delta y. Because del z by del y is equal to 3. So 3 into delta y will propagate. So that's why you have to multiply this one. It is nu r divided by what is the that. And then you take square. So here also it is del r by del r2. And then you take square. That is sigma 1, okay. But the sigma 1 will not propagate normally. Whatever constant is there, what is the effect of change in r1 on this? The new variable, that you have to take care of. That will be multiplied with that one. Now that will be multiplied with the change that you are occurring, that is delta R1 and delta R2. Change means that is deviation, you can say. So that's why the answer will be something of this fashion. You can remember this formula, very important formula for mixed, to calculate mixed SD. So del R by del R2. Proofs are there, but I am not going to proof of that one. But you can remember this one. This is overall sigma. By using some concept of RMS value and some concept of how it will propagate, you can use this one and you can remember this one. So remember this one, that is your option A. 9. What they are asking, the current, this much current, you are passing through the resistance. What the voltmeter or DC voltmeter will? DC voltmeter, you have to be very careful. You have connected a DC voltmeter. Is it a DC signal? No, it is an alternating signal, it is changing, it is AC. So if you apply this one, what DC will change? You cannot, first of all, DC voltmeter you cannot use, but you are breaking the rule. So breaking the rule means you will give some consequences will be there. So what is the consequence they are asking? That is the way. So if you apply DC, so it will treat it as a DC. What is the meaning of DC? DC means it is average value. DC means simple average. So it will take simple average value of this one. So what is the average of this one? First this. So average, for average this, you take area, this plus this, then divided by total time period. So what is the area? 12 into T, this one, 12 into T for this time period, it is 12. So total is 12 into T. For this much time period, 5 into T, divided by total time period 2T. This is the average, which is nothing but 12 plus 15 by 2. 12 plus 5 by 2, 17 by 2. that is 8.5. That's much ampere. That much ampere is flowing. But they are asking you what is the voltage across this. So voltage will be V10 will be equal to V is equal to I into R. This is your I that will kill, that the meter will sense average. Meter will sense actually voltage. So that average voltage I am calculating actually. So average voltage will be average current into resistance, that is 85 volt. And unshielded moving iron voltmeter is used to measure the voltage in an AC circuit. If a stray DC magnetic field having a component along x-axis of the meter coil appears, the meter reading will be. So obviously if it is a moving iron, iron means what is moving? Iron moves means your magnet is moving. So there is a change in magnetic field continuously across this moving coil. So if you apply, if there is outside a magnetic field comes, that will obviously affect the overall magnetic field. But that will depend in which direction it is coming. It may increase the magnetic field, it may decrease the magnetic field also. It may distort the magnetic field also. So it will be either decreased or increased depending on the directions of the DC field. How the direction is, new direction, that is the stray magnetic field that is coming. What is the direction of that one? Depending on that one, it may increase also, it may decrease also. If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.